Okay, we've been looking at univariate displays of data, and I want to jump just briefly here to the idea of bivariate data and scatter plots. Bivariate data simply says we're going to take two measurements from the same object, like somebody's height and their weight. And we want to be able to do some type of graphical display with that data also. So let's take a look at data, Finger Lakes data. This is actually data from the Finger Lakes region in New York. And what they did is they recorded the number of dead fish that had been observed, and they also recorded the pollution index by year. And these lakes actually exist up in New York, the state of New York. And you can see by the shape of these lakes why they get the name Finger Lakes. Now, here's the data. It's bivariate data. And I'm thinking, in terms of my calculator, I'm going to put the pollution index in list 1 and the deaths in list 2. Now, this information here with the years, we're not going to use that right now. We're not going to use that at all. It's an index that tells us what year the data came from, but we're not doing any type of temporal analysis, so I'm ignoring this completely. And all I'm looking at is the pollution index and the number of dead fish. Now, the basic idea behind a scatter plot is we have our x and y axes. Yeah, let me change color. I think black would look better here. Okay, over x and y axes. And the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to put the pollution index on the x-axis, and I'm going to put the number of deaths on the y-axis. So when I have a dot here, this represents a single data point with a specific value on the x-axis and a specific value on the y-axis, which as an example may be 2.5 on the pollution index, that's my x value, and 147 on the y-axis, that's my number of dead fish. So that's how we interpret a specific value. It has both an x and a y coordinate. It's the same sort of a thing that you did back in algebra. Okay, let's go and jump to the calculator and take a look at creating one of these graphs. Again, I have my data in L1 is a pollution index, and in L2 is the number of dead fish. So I'll go to second, stat plot, select stat plot 1. And make sure it's turned on. Go to the very first graphic. And you notice this graphic looks like a scatter plot. That's because it is. This is something else. Avoid this one. I want to select this one. So I will hit return. Or press the return key, enter key. And now you see this display changed. And it's going to ask you for my X list and my Y list. So my X list is going to be L1. So second one. That puts L1 in there. The Y list, the Y data is in L2, and mark is just what the calculator is going to use to put on this screen. So now I will press zoom 9 for zoom stat, and there's my scatter plot. Now, if I want to copy that, I can actually copy that onto my calculator or onto my screen, but I'm just going to set it aside for a second, and let me see. Stick it over there quickly, and I'm going to draw roughly what I'm seeing here. Seeing something that kind of looks like this. Maybe something like that. Give or take a little bit, that's kind of what I'm seeing there. So I'll go ahead and minimize that. Okay, so this 2.5 is actually right there. The 147 is actually right there. This is my very first data point. This data point right here corresponds with this data. So that's your scatter plot. We definitely want to label this, like I said earlier. This is pollution. And this is deaths. And we should actually label it with something like Finger Lakes. something to that effect. You may want to add a little bit more to the title so the reader knows exactly what it is that we're dealing with. Now, later what we'll be talking about is we take a look at the general shape of this scatter plot, and based on the shape of that scatter plot, which in this case appears to be somewhat linear, in general it's a line, that will help tell us or direct us into appropriate analytical techniques so we can describe this better.